وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، I'm your brother Abdurrahman Hassan, speaking to you from Sharjah Book Fair 2022. إن شاء الله تعالى, today I want to speak about some of the important books from English speaking, English books إن شاء الله تعالى, to Arabic speaking beginners, intermediate, advanced, inshallah ta'ala, various different sciences, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. I will speak about the best publications for it, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. But before I say all of that, there are some points I want to mention, inshallah ta'ala. Brothers, this is a market. So when you come into the market, there are some etiquettes and manners that you should observe. From them is number one, the dua, dua al-suq. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned to us, anybody who enters the market and says, la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. The Prophet told us that that person is going to, their sins are going to be eradicated, their reward is going to be increased and multiplied for them, a house will be built for them in Jannah. Righteous deeds is mentioned for the person, brothers and sisters. So do not forget to do that. Number two, brothers and sisters, you're in the market, make sure you lower your gaze. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to us as believers, men and women, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبَصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبَصَارِهِنَّ وَيَحْفَظْنَ فُرُوجَهُنَّ. So to lower your gaze, don't look around and look at the opposite gender. Lower your gaze. Number three, brothers and sisters, every manners that the scholars talk about of the streets have to also be observed here. So be very considerate about the people around you. Make sure you look around when you're walking, don't walk backwards. Don't walk forward. If you're using a trolley, don't hit it with people, elderly people. Help. Be very helpful and be very considerate, inshallah ta'ala. Uphold the manners and the morals and the ethics that Muslims should uphold, inshallah ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, here I have with me Hashiyat ibn Hisham al-Ansari, rahimahullah, the author of the kitab, Awdahul Masalik. And this is a Hashiyah that Ibn Hisham al-Ansari placed on Alfiyat ibn Malik. It's only one volume. Darus Samman published it. يُطبعُ لِأَوَّلِ مَرَّةٍ. And it's been published for the first time. So check this out, inshallah ta'ala. Come to the ma'arad and buy it. As you know, Ibn Hisham, rahimahullah, صاحب كتاب مقدمة, Ibn Khaldun, he said, يعني no scholar has come to us, they lived at the same time, more knowledgeable in grammar than Ibn Hisham. He even praised him higher than Sibawayh rahimahullah. So he said, "Anha min Sibawayh," يعني Ibn Hisham rahimahullah. And as you know, Ibn Khaldun has a very harsh view regarding the grammarians. He's not fond of them and critiques them a lot. But Ibn Hisham, he loved them. So Ibn Hisham's works, always buy it, inshallah ta'ala.
Sheikh, which hall can we find this?
You can find it in E23, inshallah ta'ala. Darus Samman, inshallah, Turkiya. Okay, and as it says in the book, يُطبعُ لِأَوَّلِ مَرَّةٍ. It's been published for the first time, inshallah ta'ala. This is another kitab, my beloved brothers and sisters, I honestly encourage all of you to get. This kitab is four volumes, and it's the first explanation of Sahih al-Bukhari. And this taba'ah is what you need to get. As you can see, it's called, the kitab is called A'lam al-Hadith fi Sharh Sahih al-Bukhari, and it's written by Abi Sulaiman al-Khattabi rahimahullah. He is awwal sharih li ba'd ahadith al-sahih. He went through some of the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. Of course, he doesn't go through all of it, and he doesn't cover all of it, and his explanation, of course, is not in great details, but it is, it's a good book to start with and read and look at. Abu Sulaiman al-Khattabi, four volumes. And it's
the tahqiq of Muhammad ibn Sa'ad ibn Abdul Rahman Al Sa'ud. Encourage you all to get bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Here is called Zadul Masir, and it's written by al-Imam Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah. This kitab is tafsir of Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah. The best publication, it's just come out. Everyone's coming to buy it. Don't lose your opportunity and chance. Come for it, inshallah ta'ala. As you know, Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah, ghaniyun ani ta'rif. Everyone knows who he is, rahimahullah. It's a 15 volume, and it is taba'a, atiqa, and it has been relied on so many different manuscripts. So far, this is the best publication for it. I'm just going to show you how it looks inside. So you can see, inshallah ta'ala, this is it. It's called Zadul Masir fi ilmi al-tafsir. And this is how it looks inside. Beautiful. And it's the waraqah is mulawwan. It's good for the eye.
Mulawwan means shit.
It's colored, so it's not white. And inshallah ta'ala, you have not just the words of Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah, but the different manuscripts, the different copies, what they say, the variations in there. So the matan of the book is being served. As for the references of the athar in there and the ahadiths haven't been really graded like that. But again, the ahadiths haven't been graded, nor have the statements of the sahabas. But what has been done is the wordings of Ibn al-Jawzi have been served very well. I encourage everyone to get it, inshallah ta'ala. It's hall number 4, inshallah ta'ala. Come and get this book, inshallah ta'ala. It's about 600 dirhams. I'm sure, inshallah ta'ala, it can be pushed down for all of you guys. Okay, brothers and sisters, here I have with me Tariq al-Maktabat al-Islamiyya wa man allafa fil kutubi by Muhammad Abdul Hayy al-Kittani rahimahullah. He was alim al-Maghrib. He's written this kitab, and this kitab is gold, haqiqatan. I got it back a few years. It talks about the history of libraries, okay? Islamic libraries. And وَمَنْ أَلَّفَ فِي الْكُتُبِ, and those who've authored books, it's a marji'. Reading this book encourages you, inspires you to read more. It also inspires you to learn about the value that books had for our great scholars of Al-Islam and what legacy they've left behind for us. One of the things we as Muslims can say without a shadow of a doubt, and we can thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for, is that we have so many works written for us in our religion, in the Arabic language, we can go back to. So this kitab is one of those books. It's يعني, like a statement I read from Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd rahimahullah, his kitab Al-Riqaba, fi Turath al-Islami. Bakr Abu Zayd speaks about how to observe and protect Islamic heritage. This kitab, and note that kitab, when you read it together, it complements one another. And here, Muhammad Abdul Hayy al-Kittani, he goes over that history and the works those scholars have written. I'm going to use this book to speak more about books and publications and Islamic libraries that existed in Andalus and Baghdad and يعني, even Maktaba in يعني, Al-Maghrib Al-Arabi that Muhammad Abdul Hayy al-Kittani speaks about a lot. I mention a lot of that, inshallah ta'ala. Buy this book, this kitab. I just bought it yesterday myself. I haven't finished reading it, I started it. It's Tariq al-Adab al-Arabi, and it's written by none other than the great scholar, Ahmed Hassan al-Zayyat, rahimahullah ta'ala. It's a great book. He was Udwu Majma' al-Lugha al-Arabiya. It's now been published. It starts from the history of the pre-Islamic poetry. It starts from there, and it carries on until the 20th century. So only one volume. It is beautiful to read, especially this kitab and the other kitab written by Mustafa Sadiq al-Rafi'i, Tariq al-Adab al-Arabi. If you can get those two books and read it together, you'll be amazed. This scholar, rahimahullah, he is a man of great knowledge. And he was a colleague of Mustafa Sadiq al-Rafi'i, Mahmoud Shakir, and the likes of these great imams. So if you look inside how it looks, inshallah ta'ala, look at it, beautiful, very well preserved. And it has all the poetries, Al-Farazdaq's poetry, Tirmah ibn Hakim's poetry, All of these are here for you, inshallah ta'ala. That's one. The other one, again, is written by the same author, Ahmed Hassan al-Zayyat. This is more to do with eloquency, balagha. So it's called Difa' anil balagha. He's defending concepts of balagha that require for a person to know and understand. Again, balagha is a science that serves i'jazul Qur'an. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala challenged mankind with the Qur'an. He says to them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِن كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِصُورَةٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ وَدْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. So the Qur'an's miracle will be known through you learning the balagha. Now come with me here, inshallah ta'ala. I've managed to finish this kitab yesterday. I bought it, 3 volumes, and I'm profound and amazed with this man. Again, his name is Ahmed Hassan al-Zayyat. It's called Wahyu al-Risala, and it has Fusul fil Adab, Naqd al-Adab, and Tadawuq al-Shi'r al-Arabi, high level. Talks about issues of politics, issues of society and sociology. He talks about it. It's 3 volumes. Again, look at it inside. Look at that. And this is really worth buying, inshallah ta'ala. Don't hold back. Barakallahu feekum. Wa jazakumullahu khayran. Brothers and sisters, this is another kitab. It's called Al-Alam al-Mashhur fi Fawaidi Fadli al-Ayami wa al-Shuhur. It's written by Ibn Dihyat al-Kalbi al-Busti rahimahullah, who died in 633 Hijriya. This kitab, you benefit from it. It's similar to the kitab Lata'if al-Ma'arif by Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali. It talks about the virtues of days, months, and it mentions masail hadithiyya, masail fiqhiyya, masail lughawiyya. He even talks about some of the names, where they originally came from. Like, why did the Arabs call it this? And why did they not call it that? And why this and why that? So there's fawaid in the names of the month that you get in this book, written by this great Imam. And the tahqiq of it, it's a majmu'a min al-muhaqqiqin. A few of scholars have come together to do the tahqiq. And rather, to be honest, this publishing house, Markaz al-Dirasat wal-Abhath wa Ihya' al-Turath from al-Maghrib, is one of those books, publishing house, where wherever they publish, they take their work time, they publish it properly. They don't just choose any random books. They select and they choose and they work on it very hard. And they use the best publishing house. They're the ones that did the kitab I mentioned before by Muhammad Abdul Hayy al-Kittani, the Tariq of the Maktabat al-Islamiyya, and those who writ in it. So this kitab, brothers and sisters, 3 volumes. Try to get it, inshallah ta'ala, and read it. This is for the advanced students of knowledge who want to look into it more. Bidnillahi al-Kareem. Barakallahu feekum. This is Raf'ul Malam an A'immat al-A'lam by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. This book, what it talks about is, it's lifting the blames from the worthy scholars. As you know, the great scholars of Islam, they do mistakes. And he explains to you, when they do a mistake, why do they do a mistake? He also explains to you difference of opinion, manners of etiquettes of differences. This book is Nafi' Mufid. And he summarizes the reasons into 3, and then he breaks that 3 into 10. Al-Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, a student of knowledge, should read this kitab with many of other books that are written by other great scholars. As-Sayyid Al-Batliyusi, who was a Maliki scholar, he also has a book similar to this. And Sahib Hujjatullah al-Baligha, he also has written a book on this field. So this is a field students of knowledge should give a lot of importance to read, especially when they want to learn fiqh and how to deal with differences. Inshallah ta'ala, here we have the kitab Al-I'lam bi Fawaidi Umdat al-Ahkam, written by the great Shafi'i scholar Ibn Mulaqqin rahimahullah. Ibn Mulaqqin is the teacher of Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. He's written the biggest explanation on Umdat al-Ahkam, the biggest in size, okay? He has benefited a lot from Ibn Daqiq al-Eid's works. So again, Ibn Daqiq al-Eid's work, you have to go through it and take that book and benefit from it. Yesterday we mentioned the explanation of Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan. But here, inshallah ta'ala, we're mentioning the explanation of Ibn Daqiq al-Eid. It is Darul Asimah. Try to get it, bidnillahi al-Kareem. With this book, it's called Iqtida' Sirat al-Mustaqim, مخالفة أصحاب الجحيم. and it's written by Al-Imam Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. This one is the one of the best tabaat, Darul Asimah. It's two volumes, okay? Get it inshallah ta'ala. If you want to get the kitab Iqtida'u Salat al-Mustaqim, get this copy inshallah ta'ala. So brothers and sisters, I have with me here Kitab Qiyamul Layl, written by Hafiz Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah. This kitab, this is the second publication for it. Second publication came out 2022. And it talks about Qiyamul Layl, the night prayer. He's not the only person who's written regarding the night prayer. Muhammad Nasr al-Marwazi wrote it. Also, Imam al-Ajurri has written a kitab on it. Ibn Abi Dunya has a kitab on it. And this is one of those books that you read. And issues that we tackled in our podcast previously on the issues of the number of raka'at that you can pray in your Qiyamul Layl, and what is the sunnah and what isn't, and are you allowed to increase from 11? Those issues, when you read these books, you get answers from it. So this is a kitab I highly encourage you to get. It hasn't been published previously a lot, and it mentions it here, يُطْبَعُ لِأَوَّلِ مَرَّةِ. It's been published for the first time. This is the second publishing, by the way. So there has been a copy of it previously. But this one, mashallah, they've worked on it even more. So I encourage students of knowledge to get this one, inshallah ta'ala, and buy it. Another kitab, inshallah ta'ala, I want you guys to buy from Darul Jawzi, is this kitab. Muhammad ibn Tahir, Muhammad al-Tahir ibn Ashur, who wrote the kitab al-Tahrir wa al-Tanwir, the great scholar from Tunisia, rahimahullah ta'ala, rahmatan wasi'a, he writ a balagha book for the students of knowledge. The kitab is very beneficial. He called it, as you can see, Mujizul Balagha, Muhammad al-Tahir ibn Ashur. The kitab was gold, because the imam is, his whole tafsir, if you read it, you benefit from balagha and etc. It's full of balagha. But when Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan came to this book and explained it, it just gave it extra weight. And as you know, Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan, he's something else when it comes to Shuruhat al-Kutub. He has a sharah, inshallah, which we're going to show. He called it Mawridul Afham, where he explains Umdatul Ahkam. There's another kitab he's written called Minhatul Allam, where he explains Bulughul Maram. He has another kitab where he explains Al-Waraqat. There's another kitab he explains, and he's like that. He explains so many books, and the books that he explains, you have to buy. Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan, okay? He is not Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan's son, as some people think. Because they hear Salih al-Fawzan, they think, oh, it's his son. No, it's not. He's another person. He lives in Qasim. He's a mu'allif. حقيقةً he's a mu'allif. Darul Jawzi is called Al-Wasilatu wal-Balagha fi Sharhi Mujazul Balagha by Muhammad Tahir ibn Ashur, written by Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan. Must get that book. And all his works, Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan, Mawaridul Afham, Minhatul Allan, Sharh of al-Waraqat that he's done. He's also explained Al-Muharrar ibn Abdul Hadi. Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan has a lot of kitabs. I've seen recently he's written a kitab on the ahkam and the rulings related to the person who's sitting on the chair when they're praying salah, the do's and the don'ts. Buy that book, inshallah. Very beneficial. Another kitab is called Sayyidul Khatir. This kitab is written by Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah. He actually wrote this book. All the thoughts that came to his mind, captured it here. It's translated in English. It's called The Captured Thoughts, right? Sayyidul Khatir. And one of the things I loved about this book and I read from it is that Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah ta'ala, one of the things he said about high aspiration is he says, كَمَالُ الْعَقْلِ عُلُوُ الْهِمَّةِ وَالْرَاضِي بِالدُّونِ دَنِي. High aspiration is a sign that a person is very smart. And the person who doesn't have high aspiration shows that they're not, their IQ is low. And it's a sign of high aspiration it's a sign of high IQ that you have high aspiration. So there's so many beneficial things in there. I believe this is a masterpiece, haqiqatan. Sayyidul Khatir is full of fawaid and benefits. It's similar to the Kitab al-Fawaid by Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah ta'ala. So what's this? This publication is the last publication that's come out, okay? And it's very good, haqiqatan. Even though there's still some mistakes in there, but humans' works is always open to mistakes. Who's gonna be perfect? The next kitab is called لطائف المعارف فيما لمواسم العام من الوظائف. This kitab it talks about what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did in every month of the year. So starting from Muharram onto every single month, what did the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam do in that month? What did he focus on? What did he not do? And funny enough, if you look at this book, if you come to the month of Rabi' al-Awwal, it doesn't mention that they celebrated the Prophet's birthday. It's not in there. It's not documented in there. No one celebrated it. The author is Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali. He's written a kitab. So he talks about the entire year. Look what his name is called. It's called Lata'iful Ma'arif. Fima limuwasimi limuwasimi al-aami min al-wada'if. Fima limuwasimi al-aami min al-wada'if. What does that mean? It means every mawsim, like the seasons in the year, like we call it Ramadan, the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, and all of that times. What are the things that you should be doing in those peak seasons in Islam? Like the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, Ramadan, the last 10 days of Ramadan, and Muharram, the fasting of Muharram, and all of that. And the day of Ashura, and all of that. He mentions evidences, aqwal for it. But you never find anything for Rabi' al-Awwal. Full stop. Nothing. No mention of the Prophet was born here, so celebrate it. So it's a good book to read and to study, inshallah ta'ala. This kitab is called Ma'arij al-Qabul Bisulami al-Wusul ila ilmi al-Usuli fi al-Tawheed. And it's written by Allama Hafiz ibn Ahmed al-Hakami rahimahullah. Muhammad Subhi Halaq rahimahullah, he read the kitab. He published it, so he did tahqiq of it. He's not the author of the kitab. The author of the kitab is Hafiz al-Hakami, rahimahullah. But he did tahqiq of the kitab. Muhammad Subhi Halaq is well known for the tahqiqat of the works of Muhammad Ali al-Shawkani. He's, mashallah, he worked a lot on it. He's worked on the kitab of Muhammad Ali al-Shawkani on Irshad al-Fuhul, if my memory serves me right. But I'm sure he, Nail al-Awtar, I know he's done tahqiq of it. Even Sheikh Tariq Awadullah has also done tahqiq of the kitab. Muhammad Subhi Halaq, the works of Muhammad Ali Shukan is his. He's worked on it. But amazingly enough, he came and he worked on this kitab of Hafiz al-Hakami. Hafiz al-Hakami wrote a nazm called Sulam al-Wusul. It's Aqidah nazm. And then he explained it himself. Hakami authored the book, explained his own book, and Halaq did the tahqiq of it. And it's three volumes. It's the best. And it's been out for many years. I encourage students of knowledge to get that, inshallah ta'ala. This kitab, it's called the Jamharatu Mustakharajat Al-Jarh Wa-Ta'deel. And it's written by Muhammad Ziyad Umar Al-Tukla. Sheikh Muhammad Ziyad Umar Al-Tukla is one of the great scholars when it comes to Ijazatul Hadith. He's got many Ijazat in Hadith. And he is currently living in Derby right now, in the UK. Okay? And this book, I've only looked at the first volume. I haven't gone through it. This book, it's basically from approximately 1,200 books he's taken from, and he's mentioned 6,000 biographies, which you won't find in the most common books of biographies. So he's a man of knowledge when it comes to the ruwat and the narrators and the scholars of hadith. He has very good knowledge of that. And he lives in the UK, so I encourage students of knowledge to try to find him and get hold of him and benefit from his books. Brothers and sisters, here I have with me Kitab Tahdhibu al-Kamal fi Asma'i al-Rijal, written by Hafiz al-Mizzi rahimahullah. And Imam al-Mizzi, the friend of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, and not only that, the teacher of Ibn Kathir and many great scholars. Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi rahimahullah, he has written this kitab called Tahdhib al-Kamal fi Asma'i al-Rijal. This kitab is originally taken from the kitab written by Abdul Ghani ibn Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi, and he summarized it into 35 volumes. Okay? And the muhaqqiq is Dr. Bashar Awad Ma'ruf. And this book is basically the names of the narrators of the six books of hadith. So Bukhari's narrators in all of his works, whether it be Adab al-Mufrad, whether it be Khalq Af'ali al-Ibad, whether it be, you'll find it here. Some people, they question whether the Kitab Khalq Af'ali al-Ibad is one of the works of Imam al-Bukhari, for example. So how would you know that it is? You go to the Kitab Tahdhib al-Kamal, okay, Fi Asma' al-Rijal by Imam Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi, and he mentions in there the Rams, the symbol of the Kitab in his book. So, and he attributes it to him. So it's one of the ways to know a book is written by an author. So try to get that, inshallah ta'ala. Right under it is Kitab Fathul Bari. Okay? This is one of the best copies of Fathul Bari by Hafidh Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, rahimahullah. He explains Sahih al-Bukhari, and it is approximately 24 volumes. 24 volumes, Hafidh's explanation. And this is the tahqiq of Sheikh Shu'aib Arnaut, rahimahullah, who passed away. It was a effort that he exerted in it. It's called Al-Risalatul Alamiyah. Al-Risalatul Alamiyah. It also was published, I think, of Mu'assist al-Risala, if I'm not wrong, but Al-Risalatul Alamiyah. Please buy this copy, inshallah ta'ala. There are so many benefits. I personally like this copy more than all the other copies I've seen. I prefer this one more over the other copies. The Taba of Darul Tayyibah, what I like about it is, of course, the issues that Sheikh Abdulaziz bin Baz mentions there, and Abdurrahman Nasir al-Barraq and all of that, it's beneficial. But like when it comes to the Fathul Bari, the words of Ibn Hajar, I love this kitab, Fathul al-Bari. Book, inshallah ta'ala, I personally liked reading it. I benefited from it. It's called Ash'aru Hudayl, wa atharuha fi muhit al-adab al-arabi. And it specifically just focuses on the poetry of the people of Hudayl. And as you know, Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah, had memorized the poetry of the people of Hudayl. He knew it from memory. ولذلك Abdul Malik ibn Qurayb al-Asma'i, he said, كَتَبْتُ شِعْرَ أَهْلُ هُدَيْلِ, I wrote the poetry of the people of Hudayl, مِنْ فَتَن, from a young boy whose name is Muhammad ibn Idris, referring to Imam Shafi'i. So he went and he took it from him. And Imam Shafi'i memorized it. And some brothers, they go for fiqh, and they go for aqidah, and they go for hadith, and all of that, but they don't give no importance to adab al-lughah. They don't give anything, no importance to poetry and literature in the Arabic language. Lidharik al-Shafi'i mentions that the reason why he memorized the Arabic poetry, okay, was, he said, so I can serve fiqh. That was my reason, he said. Rahimahullahu ta'ala. Another kitab for every student of knowledge, and it's a must, for every student of knowledge to have, is this kitab, Siyaru A'lam al-Nubala by Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, rahimahullah. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, he wrote a Tariq al-Islam, where he talks about the history of Islam, he talks about narrators, he talks about individuals, he talks about people. But some people think that this kitab, Sir A'lam al-Nubala, is a summary of that kitab. Not necessarily. There are things that you find in Sir A'lam al-Nubala that you will not find in his Tariq. So I encourage brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, to buy the kitab Sir A'lam al-Nubala, even if you have Tariq al-Islam by Imam al-Dhahabi. There are fawaid, there are nukat, there are istidrakat of Dhahabi that you find here that you will not even find in his Tariq al-Islam, okay? And one of the things I learned from Imam al-Dhahabi, and I call him Imam al-Munsifin. Dhahabi is an Imam al-Munsifin, meaning he's the Imam of the fair people. He's very fair when he talks about narrators. He mentions what is their rights and what they are, and he critiques them if they're wrong in what they are. He's not unjust. You learn from him when you're doing the biography of a person, how you should be and not be unjust. And that's one of the maqamah, the maqam the ulama mention. And these are one of the places where you mention the person's good and bad. That's one of those places when you're doing a tarjama and a biography of that person's life, you mention everything. I hope those people who would watch his video don't jump with manhajul muwazanat. That's not the moment, that's not the time, and that's not the place for it. When you're talking about somebody's life from when they were born until they died, you need to mention everything, okay? So Dhahabi does that, rahimahullah ta'ala. Right on top of that is the kitab Ruh al-Ma'ani fi tafsir al-Qur'an al-Azim wa sab' al-Mathani. And it's written by Imam al-Alusi, rahimahullah. So this is kitab Ruh al-Ma'ani, okay? Fi tafsir al-Qur'an al-Azim wa sab' al-Mathani. Written by Imam al-Alusi. This Alusi here, there's many Alusis, is the Abu Thana. Abu Thana, Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Alusi al-Baghdadi. This kitab is so beneficial, very beneficial. So many good things that you benefit from this kitab. Of course, I've read it, يعني ألوسي رحمه الله, when it comes to مسائل of Allah's speech, صفة الكلام, he has fallen short in that regard. But the kitab is really beneficial when it comes to issues of عقيدة, مسائل, not عقيدة, sorry, مسائل بلاغة, مسائل البلاغة, and يعني issues of نحو and لغة. It's very good. This kitab is very beneficial in that regard. I encourage students of knowledge to get that مؤسسة الرسالة. Okay. Another kitab, inshallah ta'ala, to get is, we already mentioned this one. Another kitab that I encourage the students of knowledge to buy is the kitab Al-Bahr al-Muhit by Al-Imam Abu Hayyan al-Andalusi rahimahullah. Abu Hayyan lived at the time of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. They met each other, and Abu Hayyan is a Bahrun. He's a Bahar, an ocean when it comes to the Arabic language, an ocean. So he's written this book. I encourage students of knowledge to buy it. Get this copy, inshallah ta'ala, Al-Risalat al-Alamiyyah. There are so many benefits in it. It's 22 volumes. So it's a kitab of tafsir that you should look into, inshallah ta'ala. And there was a relationship between Abu Hayyan al-Andalusi and Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah at one time, but then that deteriorated after Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, of course, disagreed with Abu Hayyan's يعني figure that he loved, which was Imam Sibawi. He loved Sibawi a lot, and Ibn Taymiyyah critiqued Sibawi, and this hurt Abu Hayyan. And so Abu Hayyan wrote poetries to criticize Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. This kitab I have with me is called Lum'at al-I'tiqad al-Hadi ila Sabil al-Rashad. It's Aqidah text written by Ibn Qudama al-Maqdisi. Again, this is for the intermediate students of knowledge. This kitab Ibn Qudama wrote. Ibn Qudama is a Hanbali scholar. He's the author of the Kitab al-Mughni, which is a sharah of Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi. So he's written this book, Lum'at al-I'tiqad al-Hadi ila Sabil al-Rashad. Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan has explained the kitab in this one volume. Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan goes over it and covers it. So a student of knowledge who doesn't understand the text can read the Sheikh's sharah, حفظه الله تعالى. The kitab قاعدة الجليلة في التوسل والوسيلة by Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, in two volumes, he explained the kitab, At-Turath al-Dhahabi. He explains it in two volumes, Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, حفظه الله تعالى. So these are from the سلسلة شروحات ومؤلفات of Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan, حفظه الله. So I encourage the students of knowledge who are reading this kitab, قاعدة الجليلة في التوسل والوسيلة. This kitab, Ibn Taymiyyah is talking about the issue of, are you allowed to intercede to other than these three? There's three things we all agree that you can do a tawassul with: Allah's names and attributes, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا. The second thing is al-amalu salih, righteous actions. And the evidence for that is the hadith of the three men that went into the cave. ثلاثة نفر ممن كان قبلكم حتى أواهم المبيت إلى غار فدخلوه فانحدرت صخرة من الجبل فسدت عليهم الغار. The famous hadith. You can find it in kitab Riyad al-Salihin, the first chapter of Al-Ikhlas. And the third, which we agree on, is are you allowed to intercede to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? يعني, can you do intercession through... So we mentioned Allah's names and attributes. The second one was righteous action that you've done. And the third one is, are you allowed to ask somebody who's alive, who's righteous, who's good, say, make dua for me that Allah does this for me? Are you allowed? That's agreed upon. But are you allowed to ask somebody who is dead, who is not hay, he's not hadir, nor he doesn't have the ability, are you allowed to intercede? Are you allowed to ask him? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, this book, Qa'idatu Jalila, Fi Tawassul al-Wasila, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, all of the shubuhat regarding that matter, he clears it and clarifies it. It's a kitab every Muslim, every talib ilm should try to get and read, inshallah ta'ala. And Shaykh Salih Fawzan does a nice mashallah ta'aliqat on the kitab. So get it bi'inillahi al-kareem. This kitab, inshallah ta'ala, is another kitab, and it's called At-Tahrir Fi Sharh Sahih Muslim. It's only one volume, and it's written by Qiwam al-Sunnah, Abu Qasim al-Taymi rahimahullah, the author of the kitab Al-Hujjah Fi Bayan al-Mahajjah. He's written that book, Abu Qasim al-Taymi, Qiwam al-Sunnah. This kitab is it's a qit'ah of the explanation of the kitab Sahih Muslim. He didn't explain it all, just a portion of it. And it is, the publishing house is Asfar. I highly encourage you guys to all get this kitab. Get it. Also, he has a sharh on Sahih al-Bukhari. I just asked the brother who works here. He said to me, the Sahih al-Bukhari copy is finished from him. But get the Muslim, inshallah ta'ala, before it finishes. There's about three left. Okay? Why is it so unique to get this book? The unique thing about it is, number one, the author, rahimahullah, is a 6th century imam. He died 535 Hijri taqriban, rahimahullah. And the upper you go, the better. Again, he's an imam in al-aqidah. He's an imam in aqidah. So when he talks about masail in the hadith related to aqidah, he will take it according to aqidah al-sunnah wal-jama'ah. Because he's the author of the kitab al-hujjah fi bayan al-mahajjah. So he's a great, bona fide, knowledgeable imam. Abu al-Qasim al-Taymi, Abu al-Qawam al-Sunnah. I encourage everybody to get his works. This, inshallah ta'ala, is Kitab al-Tamheed ibn Abd al-Barr, rahimahullah ta'ala. The best publication out there so far. The Tahqiq of Sheikh Bashar Awad Ma'roof. And Muassasat al-Furqan li al-Turath al-Islami. They've published the Kitab in 17 volumes. And this is the first volume for it. And it's written by Al-Imam Ibn Abd al-Barr, rahimahullahu ta'ala. Ibn Abd al-Barr is the great Maliki scholar explaining the Muwatta of Al-Imam Malik, rahimahullah. And there's a difference between the Al-Istidkar and the Muwatta. There's a difference between the two. The Muwatta, Al-Imam Malik, rahimahullah, he's explaining Ibn Abd al-Barr is explaining in the Muwatta, in the Tamheed, the Muwatta from the perspective of the Ahadith al-Marfu'at. So he's explaining the Hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Istidkar, he's focusing on the Mawqufat, the statements of the Sahabas and the Atba'u Tabi'een. So a student who wants to study the Tamheed and get it and buy it, this is what I encourage them to get, this copy. Don't get any other copy, inshallah. Ta'ala. All the other copies are very bad and there's so many mistakes and faults in there. Another kitab that I encourage you to get is this kitab is called Al-Muwa'id Wal-I'tibar Fi Dhikri Al-Khitat Wal-Athar, and it's really just known as the Kitab Al-Khitat by Al-Miqrizi Rahimahullah. This kitab is a history book full of so many benefits. One of the benefits I like about it that he talks about, no, it's not actually two volumes. It's about five, six volumes, taqriban. So this kitab, it will give you an insight into so many issues. One of the things I benefited from, it, many things, but the issue of the Mawlid and Dawlatul Fatimiyin, he talks about it very well. He discusses who they were, what type of people they were. Also, he talks about the issue of the Asha'ira and how they spread and how they grew in the Muslim world. So there's a lot of things in there. Another kitab that you have to get, I personally yet haven't got it, but inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to get it this year, inshallah ta'ala, is Kashf al-Dhunun and Asami al-Kutub wal-Funun. And it's written by none other than the famous Haji Khalifa. Okay, with the tahqiq of Bashar Awad Ma'roof. What is this book? This book is like an encyclopedia for if you want to know books in different sciences that have been written. It will tell you, for example, ilmu qard al-shi'ri, what are the books that are written. So it's like a fahras for the books. So fahris, so you go there and you get it. Scholars like it, they need it. Students of knowledge need it, desire it, want it. So inshallah ta'ala, get your copy for Kashf al-Dhunun from Mu'assasat al-Furqan al-Islami. It's in the fourth section, inshallah ta'ala. I'm at the fourth hall, inshallah ta'ala. Bi'idni ilahi al-kareem. So this is inshallah ta'ala for the beginner students of knowledge who wants to study fiqh according to the madhab of Al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah. There are generally two books that the student of knowledge should start with, Akhsar al-Mukhtasarat and this kitab, Umdat al-Talib by Mansur al-Buhuti rahimahullah. This kitab, it's either this or that. Abu Mansur al-Buhuti rahimahullah, he passed away 1050 Hijriyah and he wrote this book. There's a dispute, 1050 or 1051, there's this difference of opinion. A lot of the scholars mentioned 51. Ala kullin, Mutlaq al-Jasir, Sheikh Mutlaq al-Jasir from Kuwait, he did a tahqiq of the kitab, the best tahqiq. Before this tahqiq was Ahmed al-Tuwayan. He did the tahqiq of it previously, and another person did it. This is the public tahqiq that Mutlaq al-Jasir did, very beneficial. Mansur al-Buhuti rahimahullah, Alama Mansur al-Buhuti is the student of Yahya ibn Musa ibn Ahmed al-Hajawi, which is the son of the author of the Kitab al-Iqna' and Zad al-Mustaqna. He's the son of the Kitab al-Iqna' and Zad al-Mustaqna. So he took from the son of al-Hajawi, the ma'ruf al-Hajawi, Musa al-Hajawi rahimahullah ta'ala. Ibn Badran, in his Madkhal, he mentions this kitab is like a must for a beginner student of knowledge. And Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, rahimahullah, he's also got a kitab on Madkhal to the madhab of Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal. And he mentions this kitab as to be like a mu'tamid in the madhab. So I encourage students of knowledge to buy the works of this imam if you're studying the Hanbali madhab, inshallah ta'ala. Of course, you already know it better than I do, inshallah ta'ala. But focus on the tab'ah, try to buy this tab'ah inshallah ta'ala and get this one. May Allah bless you and all you, reward you all inshallah ta'ala. Another kitab I want to encourage all of you to read inshallah ta'ala, especially at the time that we're living in, what's happening and what's taking place, the excessive criticisms that have been directed at Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, they've been extreme. They've been coming back and forth. This kitab is called Fathul Malik al-Wahhab فالردي على من طعن في دعوة الإمام محمد بن عبد الوهاب. And this kitab is مفيد للغاية. I encourage you all to get it. It's a beneficial kitab, full of benefits, والله. And it responds to a lot of the doubts that are put regarding the Imam رحمه الله تعالى. This kitab is only one of many. It doesn't mean that it encompasses everything and he talks about everything. But a lot of the issues that are brought, it's answered here, inshallah ta'ala. A student of knowledge can read it and see for himself the answers for those doubts that are brought by people who don't really know much, to be honest. Barakallahu feekum. Okay, brothers and sisters, generally speaking, a lot of the people are used to this tafsir of Abdurrahman Nasir Sa'di rahimahullah, Taysiru Kareem al-Rahman fi tafsir kalam al-Mannan. A lot of people are used to this copy. But guess what, brothers and sisters? This year, something else has happened. This copy has come out. Let me put this away. This copy has come out. It's called Taysir al-Kareem al-Rahman fi tafsir al-Kalam al-Mannan. But what have they done? What's different? They've added on it Asbabun Nuzul wa Bayanu Gharib al-Quran. So if you open the book at the bottom, you will find under there the Asbabun Nuzul, when the verses came down, the evidences for it. That wasn't in the original copy, this one. In this copy, you don't have that there, you see? But then this is wa bihashiyatihi Asbab Al-Nuzul wa Bayan Ghareeb al-Qur'an is in there. Can you see that one? Of course, the kitab, the Taysir is still the same, nothing has changed. So I encourage students of knowledge to ask for this copy. You ask for this one, you say, I want the Taysir al-Kareem al-Rahman, I want the one that has the Asbab al-Nuzul on it. Another kitab I want you guys to all look at, inshallah ta'ala, very beneficial. Okay? It's three volumes. I want you guys to look at, which is An-Nasikh wal-Mansukh. Okay? By Abi Ja'far Ahmed ibn Muhammad Ismail al-Nahas. Okay, he talks about the verses which are abrogated and those which are not abrogated. Remember, in our religion there are verses which are abrogated and they have been taken, the rulings have been lifted. The asal of course is to try to reconcile between the evidences, but there are some ayats and some ahadiths that have been abrogated. Okay, so he talks about that, but he's focusing only on the Qur'an. So he's going to be doing the An-Nasikh wal-Mansukh in the Qur'an. And he talks about the differences of opinions of the scholars in that. So some places, you're going to find khilafat on issues of Nasikh wal-Mansukh that you don't find in other books. Another kitab that I like is the kitab Bughyatul Talab fi Tariqi Halab. Okay, Bughyatul Talab في تاريخ حلب. And it's written by Kamal al-Din al-Halabi rahimahullah. Okay, this kitab talks about the history that you need to know about Halab. So if you buy, for example, تاريخ Baghdad, which Khatib al-Baghdadi wrote, the original name is actually called Madinah al-Salam. Get this one inshallah ta'ala as well. Buy all of those books, تاريخ Ibn Asakir as well, get it. Read these books, inshallah ta'ala, as a person who wants to learn aqidah, hadith, fiqh, all of that, you have to give it some time to the history and the tariq, inshallah ta'ala. Each book, I have so much things to say about it. But the time is very, very, very restricted on us. But I hope that sheds some light on what you need to know about these books, inshallah ta'ala. This is the Muwatta of Al-Imam Malik, rahimahullah, Imam Dar al-Hijrah. And this is the riwayah of Yahya ibn Yahya al-Laythi. This is the most famous it's the most famous version of the Muwatta of Al-Imam Malik. Many people have narrated from the Muwatta from Al-Imam Malik. Yahya ibn Yahya al-Laythi is the most famous, the most common one, because Ibn Abdul Barr used this one to explain his books, At-Timheed and the Istithar. But it's not the only riwayah. There are many riwayat, Abdullah ibn Salamah al-Qa'anabi, Abdullah ibn Wahbin, Yahya ibn Bukayr. And here are the different copies. The Muwatta of Imam Dar al-Hijrah, the riwayah of Abdullah ibn Wahbin, and Abdul Rahman ibn Qasim. You can find that, inshallah ta'ala, it's just one copy, one volume. Again here, you have the copy of Yahya ibn Abdullah ibn Bukayr, al-Misri. Again, this one came out recently. Bashar Awad Ma'ruf worked on it, the Muwatta of Imam Malik, three volumes. Okay, you can get that. Inshallah ta'ala. And this is two volumes. This is the one, Abdullah ibn Maslamah al-Qa'nabi's one. Here it is, that I just mentioned. Abdullah ibn Maslamah al-Qa'nabi, his riwayah is here, of the Muwatta of Imam Malik. And it's important to have these different variations because it explains one another. I need to now take you, I'm speaking fast because there's so many books I want to go through, inshallah ta'ala. Come here with me. This kitab, I just got it yesterday, inshallah ta'ala. It's called Tarikh Madinat al-Salam. And it's famously known as Tarikh Baghdad. Okay, written by Khatib al-Baghdadi, rahimahullah ta'ala. It's called Tarikh Madinat al-Salam. Sheikh Bashar Awad Ma'ruf worked on this and it came out, alhamdulillah. And this book, a student of knowledge needs to get it, by Khatib al-Baghdadi. Again, I told you guys of Khatib al-Baghdadi, his books, الناس عيالون are in need of his works. Okay, and what's good is that the kitab تاريخ مدينة السلام, it also has a ذيل. يعني ذيل is actually a tale in Arabic, right? Meaning extra things were added onto it. So inshallah ta'ala, the ذيل is around five volumes. Now this is the ذيل of تاريخ مدينة السلام. It's just the extra that was added by here it is. So don't confuse one another. Khatib al-Baghdadi wrote Tariq Madinat Salam, and Dubaythi, he wrote the Dail on it, which is five volumes. So you can't just get Tariq Madinat Salam without getting the Dail for it. So I encourage you to get the Dail for it, inshallah ta'ala. Another beautiful book that I got here is Al-Jam'u Bayna Sahihain by Abdul Haq al-Ishbili, rahimahullah. The best version of it is here. Bashar Awad Ma'ruf is very good. Tariqh Ulama al-Andalus. Okay, and it's written by Ibn al-Faradi. He's very well known for that name. It's two volumes. It talks about and it focuses specifically on the history of the scholars of Andalus. So it's very good to benefit from. This kitab is called At-Takmina li Kitab al-Sila by Ibn al-Abbar. Okay, it's four volumes. But what you have to do, okay, this is the takmila for the kitab, okay, and then here's the dail for it, of it, which is dailu wa takmila. So that's six volume dail on it. So the point, brothers and sisters, is try to come to the maktaba of Darul Gharb al-Islami. A lot of the books here are the tahqiqat of Bashar Awad Ma'ruf. He does their works for them. And as you know, Bashar Awad Ma'ruf, when it comes to Tahqiqat al-Kutub, he's very good at it. La shakka wa la raib. You can't fault him for that. His knowledge of the books are very, very good in that regard. That's the main books, inshallah ta'ala, that I wanted to shed some light on in this, inshallah ta'ala. This kitab is called Al-Maqasid al-Hasana by Al-Imam al-Sakhawi rahimahullah, where he talks about the ahadith which are very common on the people's tongues, and it's يعني مشتهر, يعني spread on the people's tongues, but has no basis. He talks about it in this book. So inshallah ta'ala, Al-Maqasid al-Hasana. This is the best publication for it so far. The Ja'iza, they mashallah did a good job in publishing this one. Another book, inshallah ta'ala, is the Rawd al-Unuf. Suhaili's Yeah, this one is the, this is the explanation I'm currently using for the Seerah, Rawd al-Unuf, by Al-Suhayli rahimahullah. It's the sharh of Tafsir Seerah ibn Hisham. So I highly encourage every single person to get it.
Sheikh, how is this book different than the other Seerah books?
It's very lengthy. It explains it in more details. And it's of great benefit, inshallah ta'ala, for the students of knowledge. The final book, inshallah ta'ala, from the Ja'izah that I encourage you all to get is this 30-volume Sharh Sunan Abi Dawood by Ibn Raslan al-Shafi'i, the author of the Safat al-Zubad. He's a faqih Shafi'i. He's done a Sharh Sunan Abi Dawood, and the Ja'izah have done a good job in publishing the kitab. So come visit here, inshallah ta'ala, and try to get this book.
What is the story of it?
It's the fourth hall, and it's the Ja'izah. Inshallah ta'ala. This kitab, inshallah ta'ala, is Al-Risala by Al-Imam Al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah. Three volumes. It's the one that the scholars say, وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ أَلَّفَهُ فِي الْكُتُبِ مُحَمَّدِ بْنُ شَافِعِ الْمُطَّلِبِ وَغَيْرُهُ كَانَ لَهُ سَلِيقًا مِثْلُ الَّذِي لِلْعُرْبِ مِنْ خَلِيقًا. The first person to ever have written in Usul al-Fiqh. Who is it? Muhammad Idris al-Shafi'i. And this is the book he's written in, Al-Risala. So you have to get the kitab Al-Risala and inshallah ta'ala read it. In there, inshallah ta'ala, you're going to learn Masail Usuliyya, issues of Usul built on Al-Kitab wa Sunnah bifahmi Salafi Salih. And you would learn the beauty of the Arabic language of Al-Imam al-Shafi'i when you read this book. This kitab is one of his works. There's another kitab called Jumma'ul Ilm. Inshallah, if we see it, we'll show you it.
How many volumes are there?
It's three volumes. The first volume, like, is a dirasa. It's the muhaqqiq and what he says about it and things like that. But the book starts from the second volume. Okay, the first...
I've heard that this is very important for students of fiqh.
It's very important for students who want to study usul al-fiqh. And of course, Sheikh Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, what he doesn't do only is that he wrote this book in a very profound way. He goes through Masail Usuliyya, and then he mentions Furu' Fiqhiyya as an istishhad, yani to break it down and explain it to students even more. This is the best Taba'ah so far that I have. You can, inshallah ta'ala, add it to your list of to get books, inshallah ta'ala. This kitab is the kitab Hilyatu Talib al-Ilm by Bakr Abdullah Abu Zayd, rahimahullah ta'ala. This kitab is about the manners of the student of knowledge, how the student of knowledge should be towards himself, how he should be towards his teacher, how it should be towards the community and the people he's around, how the student should carry himself, the do's and the don'ts. It's a very important book, full of benefits. Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, who was senior to Bakr Abu Zayd, okay, sat down and actually explained that book whilst Bakr Abu Zayd was alive, and he himself, and Bakr was alive, and Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen was also alive. This is another book, not many people know about it, but I really think at this time that we're living in, this book is a must for everybody to read. Brothers and sisters, this kitab is gold, it's gold, it's gold. This kitab is called At-Ta'alum wa Atharuhu ala al-Fikri wal-Kitab. He talks and he responds to these people who are pseudo students of knowledge, fake students of knowledge, pretend to be students of knowledge, pretend to be ones who know At-Ta'alum, claim knowledge but really don't know, haven't studied. They haven't taken the basics in Islam. Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, he speaks greatly about this issue and the problems that it has and the harms that it has. And it reminds me all the time when I read this book, the line of poetry, وَابْنُ اللَّبُونِ إِذَا مَا لُزَّ فِي قَرَنٍ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ صَوْلَةَ الْبُزْلِ الْقَنَعِيسِ. Fake, pretending to be what you're not. And so he gives many examples, many things, many... Allahul Musta'an, examples of people who've done this, who pretended to be students of knowledge and scholars but were exposed. They were found that they don't know anything. Basics they don't know. So this, inshallah ta'ala, please buy this book and read through it, and it will benefit your Arabic language. And then Bakr Abu Zayd, rahimahullah, he was good in Arabic language. His language was very high. So buy this book, inshallah ta'ala. Whilst we add that, another kitab. MashaAllah, it's Shama'il An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked. Shama'il An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam look? By Imam Al-Hafidh Abi Isa Muhammad ibn Isa Al-Tirmidhi. Al-Imam Al-Tirmidhi, the author of the جامع. This kitab, شمائل النبي, Sheikh Dr. Mahir Yasin Al-Fahl, who now lives in Turkey, he did the tahqiq of this kitab, and Dr. Bashar Awain Ma'ruf, he did the taqdeem for him. The beauty of this book is, of course, it's mulawwan, Darim al-Jawzi, mashallah, their printing is very good like that. Of course, you can see the grading of the hadith at the bottom, if it's sahih, if it's not, if it's weak, if it's authentic. So this is one of the best tahqiqat, the tahqiq of Mahir Yasin Al-Fahl. It's very good, he did a good job at it. He's written this many years back, so I don't know, has he gone back to again and worked on it again? I don't know. But what I do know is that he's done this many years back. So I can't say to you he has recently gone back to it again. I don't know that. But it's, and of course, the reason I'm doubting it is because Mahir Yasin Al-Fahl and Dr. Bashar Awad Ma'ruf are not on the best terms now. But anyways, get this kitab, inshallah ta'ala. Another kitab that a student of knowledge should get, inshallah ta'ala, Darim al-Jawzi is full of many beneficial books, is kitab As-Sunnah by Abi Bakr Al-Khalal. And Abi Bakr Al-Khalal is called As-Sunnah. And it's two volumes. The kitab is two volumes. Written by Abi Bakr al-Khalal. And here, brothers and sisters, this kitab, you're going to find inside it so many quotes of Imam Ahmad and things that he has said and things that have been attributed to Imam Ahmad rahimahullahu ta'ala. So inshallah ta'ala, brothers and sisters, buy this kitab, read it, study it. It's a kitab fil aqidah, written by one of the great scholars of the Hanbali Madhab. Some people, they think and they assume that he's actually the student of Imam Ahmad, but he's not the student of Imam Ahmad. He hasn't studied from Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahimahullah ta'ala. So, Kitab al-Sunnah by Abi Bakr Ahmad ibn Muhammad ibn Harun al-Khalal, who died here 311 Hijriah. So, this kitab I have is called Jam' Ulum wal-Hikam fi sharhi 50 haditham min Jawami' al-Kalim. As you know, Al-Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah, he wrote 42 hadiths in his book known as Al-Arba'un An-Nawawiyyah. So what Ibn Rajab did was, he took those 42 hadiths, and he added on it 8 extra hadiths, and he made it 50 hadiths. And then after that, so now it's 50 hadiths, all of which are called Jawami'ul Kalim, comprehensive speech. قَلِيلُ الْمَبَانِي عَظِيمُ الْمَعَانِي. I mean, the wordings are little, but the meaning is vast. So what he did was, he made it 50 hadiths, and then he explained it into these 50, he explained these 50 hadiths in Rajab, rahimahullah ta'ala, and this sharah is nafis lil-ghaya. A student of knowledge, brothers and sisters, try to get this. You will find so much benefits in it that you may not even find fi shuruh ummahat al-kutub. You might find benefits in here that you will not find in the Fathul Bari, for example, or يعني شرح صحيح مسلم, you'll find it here. And the tahqiq that I like to just keep to is the one done by Tariq. May Allah bless you, all of you, and preserve you. My final message I want to send to all of you, wallahi, there's so many books I've seen, and we won't be able to go through every single book, inshallah ta'ala. There are a lot, honestly, and I've left them out, those books. But the idea is for you to get into the habit of brothers and sisters reading. Honestly, once you start reading, you will learn the different copies, the different manuscripts, the different authors, what they've written, what they've not written, what they've written but hasn't reached us yet. All of that is a knowledge you acquire through your years of reading. And wallahi, the more you read, the more you study, the more you go through books, the more you benefit, inshallah ta'ala.